So this is, it's about public communication of disaster risk reduction, and that's admittedly a very narrow part of communication for risk reduction, because how scientists exchange data between each other and how scientists and others convey that data to government decision makers is all a very important part. This chapter focuses specifically on, in a sense, the next step, and that is about scientists and government conveying risks and talking about risk with the general public. So when we are talking about communication with the general public, it might be something as, get back on here, something as explicit as an educational game on getting prepared to deal with risk, or it might be as direct as a media interview or a news report on risk. Or it might be as mundane as a popular television sitcom or a drama or something that fits in quite smoothly with people's everyday lives and interests. So we'll come back to the formats in a second, but just to recap briefly, why communicate about risk? It seems quite obvious, and the first point often comes up: to improve understanding, public understanding of risk. But often it's so much more than that. It's usually not so much telling people what to do, but rather providing information, sparking conversation, and helping people reach their own decisions about risk and how to manage it. And it's not always one way. It's often most productive if it's two-way or multi-directional communication. So really getting experts of some sort speaking with people in the general public, and also getting people within the public talking amongst themselves. And that can help gather information about risk from the public, and it can also identify some innovative solutions that might not come up without that conversation happening. And also, as was mentioned in the beginning of the session, accountability and governance is a critical part of risk reduction, and involving the public in those conversations and putting risk reduction on a popular agenda to be discussed can also be very helpful. So just very briefly, we all understand that we need to know our audience, and when we talk about the public, we do need to remember that that is literally everyone out there, old, young, rich, poor, male, female, the whole population out there. And yet if you target everyone, you target no one. So communication initiatives really do need to plan for very specific target audiences, and bearing in mind that needs to go beyond demographics. So all educated women of a certain age who live in a certain area still may not think about risk in the same way. A lot of times it comes down to something much more nuanced, such as how they feel about risk or what their experiences have been around risk. And developing those audience profiles and understanding their relationship with risk will help develop much more targeted communication. And then we come quickly onto what is it that we ought to be communicating. Often people think of increasing awareness or explaining something of sorts. What's really necessary is to take a step back and think about what is the change that you want to see within the public, within that audience, and then thinking about what to communicate. In many cases, people actually are perfectly aware what the risks are, but what's preventing them from taking action is something much more complex. Is it something around their risk perception or the cognitive biases that they hold? Is it they're not talking about it at all with anyone? Do you want to spark discussion? Are there certain social norms around risk reduction that need to be surfaced and discussed, such as fatalism and beliefs in God's role in what happens as a result? Do you simply want to encourage collective action, garner people to work more closely together? All of those things are much more complex and very different from just increasing awareness or providing a better understanding. how to communicate about risk, again, is quite nuanced. I think we all recognize that the scare tactics aren't always the most effective routes for risk communication. And really what it comes down to is knowing your audiences inside and out and investing in very in-depth research to understand not only their relationships with risk, but also what kind of media they use, how they communicate, with whom they communicate, when they do that communication will help you insert yourself as a very natural part of conversations that they're already having. So really the point is to meet audiences where they are with risk in their everyday lives rather than imposing a conversation about risk on them that frankly they might not really want to have. And in order to encourage the public to open up and think about really in a meaningful way risk, it's critical to be clear, to use very clear jargon-free language, but also relevant to their everyday lives and engaging and quite practical as well. So think about what it is that the audience wants to discuss and then work your issues into that. And again, I can't emphasize enough that getting people talking about risk is a critical part of communication, and so is working with others. And that means working with many different organizations that you might not naturally work with. And it goes beyond hiring public relations or communication companies, but really developing long-lasting relationships with people who can communicate regularly with your target audiences and help bring them into talking about risk as well.